Question Mark and Mysterion's 1966 hit 96 Tears was successfully stranglerized into a top 20 hit. But by this time, tensions were beginning to show.
Many people will tell you that they're your friend. You believe them, you need them for what's round the river bend. Make sure you're receiving the signals they send.
And in 1990, Hugh Cornwell finally decided,
brother,
it was time to leave the band.
You've only got two hands to lend.
The atmosphere around the Stranglers was very, very tense most of the time. I can relax more and enjoy what I'm doing a bit more now.
And why was it tense?
Just very, very volatile people, you know. Me included, I suppose. And you feed off each other, and I became very volatile and unpredictable and stuff. And there's nothing wrong with being unpredictable.
No.
But it can get in the way of creativity.
When Hugh left, the choice was stark. Do we stop the band or not? And Jet and Dave didn't see any reason to.
The Stranglers has never really ever been a static institution. It's been an evolving and changing institution over the years, but with a basic core, which now we could describe as Dave, myself and JJ, that's always been there.
Obviously, when you change a musician, the sound changes.
I definitely thought, well, if we are going to continue, I want a singer who just sings, who's a bit of more of a focal point, because I always thought Stranglers lacked a focal point. It was Hugh and myself, and I wanted a singer. So the singer found us, Paul found us, and he knew a lot of the material. He had a great voice, and he was, you know, as a focal point, he was a perfect person.
I did understand that the fans had a particular way, and they were particularly possessive about their band, which most long-term fans are.
One of them looks closer, he's got a monkey on his shoulder, and the monkey's getting thriller, but his eyes are underground. He's just hanging around. He's just hanging around.
It's a difficult thing. There was a point where I thought it'd be easier to be Mick Jagger than it would to be Hugh Cornwell, because there was a very defined attitude. He had his way, and that was that, and there was no way I was ever going to be like that. The difference between me and Hugh is obviously Hugh was a static performer, but Hugh had to play guitar, and I don't.
Recently, new guitarist Baz Warren has been drafted, following in the footsteps of John Ellis. Or is it Hugh?
Hugh Cornwell obviously was the man who everybody associates as the Stranglers guitar player. Very innovative and kind of left the centre a little bit off the wall in his guitar playing and his approach. I mean, I only know this because I like to learn a lot of these bits and bobs. John Ellis is a very good guitar player, a little bit modern, you know, more modern than he's thinking in terms of equipment and his style and everything. But I kind of like to think I fall somewhere in between the two. I've got a bit more of a raw sound. But John did a lot of nice little bits and bobs, and I like to try and keep that living as well, because, I mean, he was in the band for 10 years.
I just didn't think the people that they brought in were going to be the people I would have thought. I was completely surprised when they brought in who they did.
From a live aspect, the show's much more exciting now. Paul definitely gives it energy, whereas before, JJ and Hugh used to stand left and right of the centre of stage, and there was just, like, this art and this aggression, and that was the sort of the thing the Stranglers were about at the end of the day. Now, obviously, Paul takes centre stage, and the spotlight is on him much more, so he has a harder job to do.
I think that's the great thing for me about it, is that I can sort of do 8 cracking up-tempo songs or pretty mean songs, if you like, and then stop the show and do something very beautiful, you know, like Strange Little Girl, which I think, for me, is possibly one of the best tunes the Stranglers have ever had.
One day, see a strange little girl look at you.
One day, see a strange little girl smiling blue. She'd run to the town one day, leaving home and her country fair. Just beware when you're there.
What if you love the Stranglers, but you just can't get enough? Well, there's always a tribute band. Websites on the Stranglers are thriving on the internet. There's even stranglers.martins. These days, JJ is very busy. What with the Stranglers, solo acoustic tours, and of course his karate club.
So this is the Shidokan Karate Kickboxing Dojo, and there's a couple of my nutty students. It's Tim and Fee. Their own Clark here in King's Cross, downtown London, I suppose. Funky King's Cross.